Lieutenant General Delphine Bangit will take command of the armed forces of the Philippines at a very crucial time in the country's political history. In 2 months' time, Filipinos will troop to the polls for the first nationwide automated elections. And there's a healthy amount of skepticism if the elections will reflect the will of the people. General Bangit is closely identified with President Arroyo, having served as the head of the Presidential Security Group, or the PSG. Tomorrow morning, the Armed Forces puts on a change of command ceremony at the grandstand of its headquarters in Camp Aguinaldo here in Quezon City, where the outgoing Chief of Staff, General Victor Ibrado, who is retiring as he turns 56, turns over the reins to Lieutenant General Delphine Bangit. The ceremonies are steeped in tradition and are rich in military history. They are a formal, symbolic passing of responsibility, authority, and accountability of command from one leader to another. It is where the outgoing leader is given a chance to say goodbye to those who have been under him and for the new commander to meet personnel. And it is where the outgoing leader formally relinquishes command and where the new leader assumes command. Lieutenant Colonel Romeo Brawner of the AFP's Public Information Office joins us tonight to talk about the ceremony and tradition that we will witness tomorrow. Good evening, Colonel Brawner. Thank you for being here.
Yes, good evening, Pia.
Yeah, siguro before we talk about ceremony tradition, just a little reaction to what we were talking about with Dr. Clarita Carlos earlier.
Yes, well, I heard most of the discussion. And, well, what we're trying to tell the public is that the Armed Forces of the Philippines is a professional organization, such that it really doesn't matter who sits down as the Chief of Staff of the AFP. In other words, we're not really personality-based. So, whether we have a chief of staff who stays on for 3 years or for 1 year or even less, the organization will continue to perform its mandate and accomplish its mission because basically all the systems are already in place and it's just a matter of implementing this. Of course, with the vision and the guidance of the chief of staff.
And that's essentially what the change of command ceremony is really all about, no?
Yes, that's right.
You can change your leaders, but the continuity is there.
That's right. That's right.
Okay.
Yes. Now going to the ceremony itself. The ceremony will be composed of five parts. The first part would be the arrival honors.
Yeah.
First, we're going to welcome the incoming chief of staff, and then we're going to welcome the Commander-in-Chief, our President, Gloria Macapagal Arroyo.
Yeah. And there are arrival honors for them because they because the incoming Chief of Staff has not yet taken over. Kumbaga,
yes,
hindi niya, kumbaga, hindi niya teritoryo yung campo. No? That's what it means.
That's right, yes. Okay. So the outgoing Chief of Staff will be there to welcome them. We would just like to inform the public that they don't have to worry. There's nothing to worry about because your armed forces is a professional organization.
Yeah. When you say there's nothing to worry about, are you trying to address, you know, all these fears? Kanina, sabi nga ni Doctora Carlos, parang we've made up our own ghosts about...
Yes, that's right. I'm so glad that Professor Carlos mentioned that. Because really, there's no basis for all of these speculations. And that... in fact, General Bangit is one of the signatories in a covenant. And in that covenant, we the whole armed forces and the Philippine National Police have vowed to make this coming elections an honest, orderly, and peaceful, credible election.
Covenant? Who made this covenant?
It's a covenant between members of the clergy, members of the armed forces of the Philippines, and Philippine National Police.
Okay. Thank you very much, Colonel Romeo Brawner of the Armed Forces. Maraming salamat. Thank you for being here.
You're welcome, Pia.